Ladies and gentlemen, you are now looking at the iridescent glow that is the Hermigan Ultra. The dance of interstellar dust within the supernova is what makes this sight so rare and so popular among visitors to the Hermigan Aurora. Luckily for you folks on Dreamweaver 9, the conditions today are perfectly clear, ideal for a sighting of this unique chemical miracle.
Color selected.
At its finest, ladies and gentlemen, the Hermigan Aurora is enough to make you believe in God all over again. Astral Dreams has been proud to bring you the excursion to the Centaur B star system today. The Dreamweaver 9 is now bringing you back to 30241.
In the Primhotel foyer, so that we can make your next journey with us even more fulfilling.
Rats in a sewer, my friends. You're rats in a sewer.
Hey.
Hey.
Here we go then. Here's a health and safety. Engine report. Customer satisfaction survey.
Happy campers.
There was a complaint about the sound quality on deck 3 again. Are you ever gonna fix that speaker? A lot of dust out there today.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I used the Viz Augment. I don't think anybody noticed it, though.
Look at the sorry state of man.
What the fuck is that?
It's my happy time. Quiet down, Tonto. Let's do this and then we can head home. So, next week we have 2 package tours to the ice floes on Prickma 27.
I'll do those.
Bit keen, aren't we?
I like the ice floes. They're pretty.
Then we got a pre-booked wedding party heading to the Sybil Nebula.
Do they need a band?
Already booked it from Primus 3. Had the honor of listening to the demo. Musical taste of these people defies fucking belief.
Put it on there.
We're gonna pour hot oil down my ears. You fancy a beer or 3? End of the week?
I gotta get home. Barbara's waiting for me.
Oh, is she now?
I'd invite you back, but, you know.
I know. Barbara's getting ready for Primo Central. Transfer confirmed?
Not yet.
And this Primo does look to keep a man hanging on.
I am gonna get it. It's just a question of process.
Well, it better be. That girl's dreaming of the high life, my friend.
On the door, there is a sign saying closed. I wonder what it means.
Do you want to get the loop back to the condos?
I think I'll see this to the end.
Just reached an interesting plot point.
Can you read our soul? We're closed. There's an IMT console in the Premier Hotel for any online reservations. There's also a customer care number right in front of your fucking eyes.
I got it. Hello there.
Oh, my.
I'm sorry. We're not open. We'll have to come back next week.
Miss Gordon has lost her hearing.
Excuse me?
Miss Gordon is deaf.
I see.
My name is Irma Gordon, and I want you to take me on a tour.
I understand, madam, but we're now closed. Can you tell her that there are no tours until next week? I can give her a physical handout of our available destinations, if she likes. But if she's not proficient on the network system, she'll have to come back on Monday.
I want you to take me on a tour to Earth.
Didn't you
hear them, man? We're closed, sweetheart. All right.
She's deaf. She's deaf.
Closed, shut. No happy holiday today.
She said she wants to go to Earth.
Well, she's not deaf. She's crazy.
Miss Gordon has traveled a long way from her home on Riga 2. She wishes to charter a ship to take her to Earth.
Listen, my cranky little pal, we can't take Miss Gordon to Earth because Earth no longer exists. We don't take passengers to non-existent destinations. Strict company policy.
Miss Gordon is 342 years old. She flew the craft personally to get here from Riga 2.
Then she can stay at the Primo Hotel, fly back home tomorrow. I tell you what, lady, because it's the end of the week and I like your face, I'm going to give you an Astral Dreams promotional coupon entitling you to a free cocktail on the house when you book your Primo Hotel room. Any cocktail of your choice, except the Primo Bellini, where there is a two-bit surcharge. You cannot say fairer than that.
She has 2 kilo positive to pay you.
Excuse me?
She is willing to pay Astral Dreams 2 kilo positive to take her. If you're wondering about method of transaction, Miss Gordon does not have a cyber account, so she would have to pay you in cash.
This is Andrew Zeprima 241. I need an urgent data feed on Earth, a planet in the solar system. 2483B65, now extinct. Also need a matchup on current Astral Dreams tour destinations. Closest approximation to size, color, tech, and specifications.
We have 6 matches to your request.
Okay, give them to me. Too far. Way too far. Too big.
Do you want to tell me what you're doing?
Jesus, that's pink. F was not pink. Okay, this is more like it. M for 3 days hyperflight, 1 moon, 3rd planet in 9. In a solar system dominated by 1 major sun, blue color. Perfect match, my friend.
That's not blue, it's gray.
It's bluey gray.
It's a dead rock. Doesn't even have any oxygen.
She doesn't want to breathe it. She wants to see it.
I'm not doing it.
Look, she wants Earth. We give her Earth. It takes us a week. We cancel all tours. We submit a TC-32 to maintenance central, telling them that the Dreamweaver 9 is damaged.
It isn't damaged.
Then I'll damage it. I'll cherry the engine and I'll return. The crone's happy. She goes back to a weird little outpost in God knows fucking where. We keep a visit off the books. No paperwork, nothing. And you and I are 1 kilo positive richer. It's 5 years' salary, Brian. Imagine what we could do with that.
You do what you want, but I'm not going to blow my chance at Primo Central doing this crazy shit.
You have to. It's a 2-man craft minimum. It's Barbara.
Paul.
Leave it to me.
Don't say a fucking word. Hey, babe.
Where are you?
I'm still at work. Something came up. I'm sorry.
Okay. Are you on your own?
Yeah, I am. I'm just about to walk out the door.
Have you heard anything?
About?
What do you think? About the transfer?
Can we talk about this when I get home?
I think you should check your vid mail, Brian.
Okay.
Hey there. This is Linus Primo. I wanted to take the opportunity to message you personally to say that, unfortunately, this time you did not succeed in your application to transfer to head office here at Primo Central. I know this must come as a disappointment to you, as this is your...
fifth.
Application.
You see, I was under the impression we'd be here for 2 years. It's been 4 years, and something tells me it's going to be six. And still, I do my hair 3 times a day, and still, I go to the Primotel bar and I sit alone.
I'm gonna deal with it.
You don't get it, do you? You don't mean anything to them. So how can you possibly deal with it?
Okay, folks, we're just passing Omega 5, well known for its high luminosity, which you would normally see out your window.
Sadly, with a lot of dust cloud today, and I'm not sure you'll be lucky in that regard. And then we'll be traveling past Alpha Centauri until we reach Solar System 2483B65, home of planet Earth.
Your caster fireball, Miss Gordon.
Thank you.
With double the vodka as you requested.
Hmm.
Can I get you anything, sir?
Mm. My grandmother was 279 years old when she died. Spring chicken compared to me, but at the time it was an achievement. I remember her sitting on our porch on Riga 2. She had me on her knee, and she told me about her life on Earth as a child. Her father had a cabin in the forest, a place called Carolina. The cabin was made of a wood called oak, I believe. He was a logger. He was a real woodsman. Had some opinions that wouldn't go down very well today.
My grandmother's name was Laura Cade. She married my grandfather.
Bill Gordon, hence my name, Irma Louise Gordon. She told me that there was a place about 5 miles from the cabin called Elk River Falls. It's a beautiful waterfall cascading into a natural pool of water so clear you could see the bottom. Well, I don't really know if I should tell you this, but on summer days, she and Bill would head over to the falls and they would swim naked. Not a stitch on them. She told me that was the best feeling she'd ever had. And I always remember thinking, I would love to see that place, to swim in that clear water. Elk River Falls, Carolina. That's where I want you to take me.
You should tell her that we can't necessarily locate specific destinations.
Of course, you're going to tell me that things have changed, that Earth back then is not Earth today, or some such thing, but if my life has taught me anything, Mr. Norton, it is that some places want to change, and some places don't want to change. And I think I know which one Elk River is. Do you?
Does the Dreamweaver always fly with such a small crew?
Well, there'd normally be four, including hospitality and security, but because of the late booking, we couldn't reach the right people.
And Mr. Andrews? Does he normally fly with the Crofts?
Sometimes. When there are VIPs like yourselves on board.
Why was no paperwork completed before we left?
Well, we'll do that when we get back. We didn't want to burden her with any formalities.
You took her money?
Yes, as a deposit.
Mr. Andrews took all of her money.
Look, we're here, aren't we? This is what she wanted.
Miss Gordon is old. She trusts people. She is very old.
Yes, she is.
Miss Gordon has a heart condition. She will die in the next 2 months.
I'm very sorry to hear that.
This will be her very last trip.
Excuse me. Sorry, I knocked on the door. I don't think you heard me. Your complimentary hot beverage, madam.
Thank you, young man. Just leave it on the table.
Good night.
And stay a while.
I should really be going.
I'm sure Mr. Andrews is more than capable of flying this craft by himself.
I suppose he is.
I don't often use this, as it can be more of a barrier than an aid, but just for today. Now, just speak normally. Don't mumble. Tell me about yourself.
Oh, there's not much to tell. I was born on Primo 76. It's a nice place. My father was an administrator for Premobility, the parent transport company. When I graduated, I just fell into leisure and tourism.
Do you like it?
Yeah. It's a good career path. We'd like to eventually end up at Primo Central.
We?
I have a girlfriend, Barbara.
I bet she's pretty.
She is. We've been together 5 years.
And why haven't you married her?
I plan to. When the time's right.
Do you love her?
Who, Barbara? Of course.
What's wrong?
I don't know. Kind of feels like I'm on the record. Like I've ended up in court somehow.
Are you afraid to testify to your love, Mr. Norton?
No, not at all.
That would suggest that you are not certain in your choice.
I love Barbara. We just...
We just what?
Don't always want the same thing. That's all.
She wants Primo Central, doesn't she?
Yeah.
And you? What do you want, Mr. Norton?
I should go.
Good night, young man.
I'll show you who's new or fucking primo.
Alright folks, watch through the window straight ahead. You'll be in for a nice surprise.
Is that it?
Yes. Solar system 2483B65.
I can tell. I can feel it in my body.
Girl happy?
Yeah.
We're making her dreams come true, man. Quick spin around it, then we can head home.
What are you gonna do with the money?
Just a question I was asking myself. Take a tour, maybe. Figure we deserve to be a passenger for a while.
And give up the job. Retire someplace small, who knows?
I might go live next door to the old lady.
Why, what about you?
Don't know.
I do. Nice condo in Primo Central for Barbara Norton. Ring on the finger. Dinner parties with the smart set.
It's what you want, isn't it?
But good on you, Norton. You deserve it. Me, I'm trash. Got no illusions. You? You got class.
I think we should tell her.
You are kidding.
Emperor's just gas and rock. There isn't anything for her to see.
So?
We're ripping off an old lady so you can go on a holiday and so I can move somewhere I don't actually want to go.
We're not ripping anyone off. We're weaving dreams. We're artists, me and you.
Con artists.
What other type is that? We change mildly blue light from meteor showers into chromatic heaven. We turn up the volume in tiny particle collisions and make them blast like stars exploding.
Is it worth it?
What are you talking about?
Selling people these packages of pre-digested happiness. I mean, there's gotta be more than this. Hasn't there? I'll go.
Norton, you don't say a fucking word to her. Do you hear me?
You are, Mr. Norton. I've been having a terrible trouble with this robe. Hooks and eyes are so rare today, and RB29 hasn't a clue how to dress a woman. You're probably wondering what this dress is and where I got it from. It's my grandmother's, from Carolina. A hand-me-down to my mother and a hand-me-down from my mother to me.
I somehow kept the moths of Riga 2 from devouring it. Nothing very special. But for this occasion. Would you? My grandfather would do this for my grandmother. My mother remembered it vividly. Of course, Bill Gordon was quite the pioneer. He's the one that wanted to leave Earth for Riga, too. Back then, everyone was interested in adventure, the unknown. Some people thought that they might even reach God.
Do you think you could reach God, Mr. Norton?
Maybe when I was a kid, I did. In fact, I used to dream we'd break into whole new universes. There were still corners we hadn't been to back then. But now it's all charted. There's no mystery anymore.
Oh, but there is. People say we know everything. Everything is explained. Down to the molecules, the atoms, the quadrons, the minimons. Every dot accounted for. But here. Here there will always be mystery.
Folks, we are entering the Earth's solar system.
We will shortly be able to orbit the Earth before completing our homeward journey.
What did you say?
We're nearly there.
Nearly where, Mr. Norton?
Earth. Where else?
I'll be 29, you can go on. I have a personal question I want to ask Mr. Norton. I'm nervous. Suddenly. It's not like me. How do I look?
Beautiful.
Well, thank you.
You don't know what I said.
Oh, but I do. I hear some people better than others. You're a gentleman, Mr. Norton. I want to show you something. This is my grandmother, back in the day. And she's with my grandfather, Bill Gordon. That's why when you opened the door in the office, I knew everything would be all right. I dreamt you, Mr. Norton, deep in my heart. And I think maybe you dreamt me too.
Yeah, listen, I need to talk to you about something.
Is there something wrong with the ship?
No.
Okay, well then I don't really understand why this just can't wait until tomorrow.
I don't want to live on Primo Central.
What do you mean?
I mean I don't want to live there. I never have. I only ever wanted it for you.
Look, it's the middle of the night. I don't want to talk about this right now.
I need to know if you want me, or if it's just that life that you're dreaming of.
I am not having this conversation right now.
Do you ever dream about me, Barbara? You don't, do you? It's okay. I don't dream about you either. Not anymore.
What are you trying to say?
I don't know.
Have you met someone else? Brian, you listen to me. I want you to turn the ship round and get the hell back here right now. Do you hear me? Right now! What happened? The connection went.
It's fine. I've got to go.
No, talk to me. What is happening up there?
Doesn't matter, Barbara.
No, Brian! Brian!
All right, take your time, why don't you? We're just passing Mars, folks.
What's with the dress? Are we having a hold down?
There you go, Miss Gordon. The God of War himself.
No, 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 this is wrong. Can't you see? What are you playing at, man? Mars is red. Everyone knows that.
I don't think so. Your memory must be confused.
I may be deaf, sir, but my mind is as sharp as a razor. And Mars is red. Mr. Norton, will you please tell that man to stop fooling me around?
You don't say a fucking word to her, do you hear me?
Mr. Norton? Say something.
Miss Gordon, there's something you should know. 60 years ago, there was an electromagnetic event in Earth's solar system causing major radioactive damage to Saturn, Mars, and Venus. Saturn lost its rings. Mars turned from red to the pale green of phosphorus. Venus became yellow and gained one ring.
Are you sure? Mr. Norton, is this true?
Yes, I'm afraid so. I'm sorry that we didn't tell you earlier, but we didn't know how you'd react.
Oh, Venus, with one ring. Oh, how beautiful it is, look.
One more thing, Miss Gordon. The radioactive event changed Earth also. It's still blue, but it's not the blue of life.
I understand. You're preparing me for a shock. But as long as it's Earth, I know I'll feel it. Its present state may be different, but its history is undeniable. Oh, take me closer.
Norton, we can't get too close.
Hold my hand. Look at it. There's an unknown here. Can't you feel it? Where's Carolina? The rest of the Earth may be gray, but Carolina's green and blue. And the blue is rich and clear. Not this mud blue of rock, but the limpid blue of a mountain stream.
I don't know if we're gonna see that.
Oh, yes, we are. Close your eyes, Mr. Norton. Close your eyes with me.
Color selected.
Oh, take me down. I have to touch it. Please, let me be on Earth for one sweet moment.
No way. We orbit the thing, then we go.
What does he say?
Mr. Andrews said we can land the craft. We're gonna land on Earth. We're gonna land in Carolina.
Oh, Bill.
This is not safe. Can't see a fucking thing.
Just keep it steady.
You know we're gonna kill it before she lands. Okay, set. Get ready, Miss Gordon.
She's a gentleman.
What happened to the color?
Where's the color gone?
The bust of Esimeter.
RB 29!
We have landed in the wrong area. We need to take off and land again.
No way, this is as far as I go.
But we need to see Carolina. Miss Gordon wishes to swim at Elk River.
No fucking way. No one talked about swimming. This is a strictly spectator-based tourist experience. If she wanted the immersive element, then she should have gone with Primo Feel. They've got oxygen tanks, suits, the whole thing. They walk, they swim, they get all cuddly and cozy. We don't. Look, but don't touch.
This is not where Miss Gordon wants to go.
This is the only Earth she's gonna get. And if you wanna get back home safe, I suggest you play ball with me.
You've 1 hour. Then we leave.
Why is Mr. Andrews so angry?
He's just tired.
Is this it, then?
No. No, it isn't.
Mr. Andrews said there weren't any suits.
Mr. Andrews doesn't know everything.
Do you know what you're doing?
Yes. I do. Your astral dreams viewing suit, madam. You'll have to hitch that dress.
And who's the other one for?
Who do you think?
Then I have one request, Mr. Norton. I have a hunch it'll fit you perfectly.
Thank you.
is she?
Miss Gordon is resting. She's disappointed now, but that will pass.
Yeah, whatever. You know the truth, right?
The truth? None of us know that, Mr. Andrews. This planet isn't Earth for me, but for Miss Gordon...
This planet isn't fucking Earth for anyone. It's toxic, it's sterile. Makes me sick just sitting on it. Got a headache the size of Primo Central. There's something wrong with the temperature control. It's baking in here. Norton, where do you allow you?
Reporting status. We're moving. Visibility is low. Progress is slow.
But steady.
Oh, Jesus. Oh.
Norton, those suits only have auxiliary tanks. Miss Gordon, this isn't Earth. Repeat, this isn't Earth.
She can't hear you.
Get it back. They're gonna die, you bastard.
You lied to her. You stole her money. Who's the bastard?
Get back! Run now!
Do you hear that?
Norton, can you hear me? Get back here. You only have 30% oxygen levels. You need to get back here right now.
Repeat.
Can you hear me?
We found a forest, Dad.
Okay, just turn around, mate.
Get back here.
Listen!
I'm warning you, Norton, I'm leaving.
Can't you hear it?
Norton! I'm taking your money, you arsehole. 2 kilo for me, and then I'm fucking out of here. Norton!
Irma!
Come.
knew we'd make it.